Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Dr. Becky Wiesrumpf, and I'm the director of music here at this wonderful church. And I want to thank you especially for being so agreeable about wearing masks and being socially distanced. About a month ago, I was contacted by artists, and we thought we were going to have to cancel today because we didn't want to require vaccination status here, as they do at Artis-Naples. And rules are rules. And the compromise was that we would have the masks on up over the nose as appropriate and social distanced. I promised them that you would do that. And so we're sort of going to be standing on the side because I don't know, they could show up and see masks down and not be happy with me. And I promised them that that's what we would do. And so I can't thank you enough for, we only had one couple that left. So, but thank you for supporting the young people. And again, I didn't make the rules. I'm just following. This church is just a wonderful church, and I'm sure most of you are here because of jazz. And so I'm going to invite you to come later this month, and you won't have to wear a mask. It is a concert here on March the 27th, and it's at 3 o'clock. And we're going to be featuring that wonderful pianist from Miami, Brandon Goldberg. Remember Brandon? He's 16 now, and his concert was the last concert before we shut down 2 years ago. And Dan will be here on trumpet, and Lou Delgado, give Lou a hand right here. Yay. And Glenn Basham will be here on violin, and Chuck Bergeron, the wonderful bassist from the other coast, and Tony Vigilante will be here. And so that will be at 3 o'clock. You can go on the church's website at naplesucc.org. Okay. Also, we have a YouTube page, and if somebody didn't come for some reason today, or if you want to hear it a second time, you're more than welcome to go and listen to it again on our YouTube page. And I am going to just give you a little hint that halfway through the program, we are going to take an offering. Years ago, Dan and I talked about, they used to be here every Wednesday afternoon from 3 to 5 o'clock. And that sort of happened at our house one night, remember, for dinner. And Dan said, I don't know where we're going to rehearse. And I said, why don't you come over to our church? And I must say that that first couple of months, this was the first time they'd ever met, the staff almost killed me because they weren't at the level they are today. But anyway, and so he's been so gracious that every year this is their community outreach. And we had planned to take an offering from one of our mission partners, but because of everything that's happening in Ukraine, through the United Church of Christ, that's where our offering will go today. So our pastor will tell you, our pastor, Dawson Taylor, will tell you more about that when that time comes, okay? But thank you, and please just keep those masks up and over your nose so we don't have to say anything, okay? Because I don't want to get in trouble. Kathleen Van Bergen is taller than I am. So give them a warm welcome, Dan Miller and the Youth Jazz Band.
Good afternoon. How's everybody doing today? Well, I'd like to welcome everybody here to the Naples United Church of Christ. And Becky Weiss is an incredible individual, and we can't thank her enough for her generosity. When this band first started, this is the seventh season, and the first year we were at Artis-Naples in a room called Studio 9, which is, if you take a three flights of stairs and you walk down a hall, you turn right at the boiler room. You go through the boiler room, up another half flight of stairs, and there's Studio 9. And Lou looked at me, and he's just like, I don't have to come every week, do I? And it was also a room that was 25 by 15. Now, I don't know how many spatial engineers there are here, but we put a group of this size inside a room that was 25 by 15. So, of course, when Becky and I were talking, and she immediately offered this incredible, incredible sanctuary for us to rehearse in every Wednesday with this incredible piano and the beautiful sound here. And we rehearsed here every Wednesday for 5 years. And now they built this gorgeous new space adjacent to the Baker Art Museum over there that has three rehearsal facilities, and we're rehearsing there. But like Becky mentioned, we always want to do our outreach concert here with this youth ensemble because she gave so much to us and Dawson and everyone here, and it's the least we could do to thank her and this congregation and everyone here. So thank you very much, Becky. Thank you. So we're going to get things started, and we're going to be playing a great program of music from the Count Basie Orchestra and the Duke Ellington Orchestra, and we're going to start things off with an arrangement by Billy Byers, and this is off a record called Hits of the 1950s and 60s from the Count Basie Orchestra, and this album is great because they did a lot of the pop tunes that were big in the 1950s. One Mint Julep, a lot of great tunes, and we're going to be playing a couple things from that today. But this one emanates from the genius of Henry Mancini and an arrangement from Billy Byers, and this is Moon River.
Thank you.
Moon River from the pen of Billy Byers, and in the role of Count Basie, Mr. Jameson Moore, ladies and gentlemen, on the piano. We also heard from Grayson Peterson on the trumpet. And, of course, we have a wonderful lead trumpet player you'll hear featured all afternoon, Mr. Ian Lawfer on the lead trumpet. Right. Well, we'd like to continue right now with a composition that's associated with the Stan Kenton Orchestra. And this one comes from the 1970s from the pen of trombonist D. Barton. And this is one that I like to do quite often with these bands, especially to feature the trombone section. It is one of the great big band arrangements of all time, in my opinion. And this is a beautiful, beautiful arrangement that features our wonderful trombone section. And this is based on a standard from the great Jimmy Van Heusen. And I think we'll hear from Jameson Moore once again, now shedding the role of Count Basie and stepping into the shoes of Stan Kenton. And Mr. Connor Stroh on a muted trumpet. And the trombone section. And this is Here's That Rainy Day. The trombone section, ladies and gentlemen.
Stand up. Take a bow, trombones.
The trombone section.
Mr. Connor Stroh on the trumpet. Connor Stroh on the trumpet. Jameson Moore on the piano. And once again, Ian Lawfer on the lead trumpet. Ian Lawfer. Well, it's time to play the blues, and we're going to take another page from the Count Basie book, and this one comes from the pen of the great Neil Hefti. And if you're not familiar with the name Neil Hefti, you're definitely familiar with his music, because he wrote extensively for television and film, and Frank Sinatra as well. Some of his more famous things, the theme from The Odd Couple, the theme from the original Batman TV show with Adam West, and so many great tunes. And he wrote for the Count Basie Orchestra a famous record called The Atomic Basie in 1957 that featured all of his incredible compositions that the band plays to this day. And this is one we like to play, and it's going to feature a number of the fine young soloists on this band. And this is Neil Hefti and Count Basie's Cherry Point.
One, two, three, four.
Let's see, we heard from Chris Socher on the piano. Chris Socher. Sam Eisenberg on the trombone. Josh Costapozo on a tenor saxophone. Shreya Rajaram on the trumpet. Jack Moore on the trombone. Abraham Hernandez on the vibraphone. Naomi Nerline on the trombone. And I just got to say something about the last soloist. We are so fortunate. He's been a member of this band for how many years? 3 years, right? 2 years? Yeah, we had that pandemic year where we didn't do anything. That's right. And this guy is so swinging. And we had him and Carlos Barreto last year together, and they made quite a tandem. And I was just like, he's a senior this year. And he just is swinging so hard and plays so great with both our drummers. And I was just like, I just want him to be playing bass all year. I didn't want to hear anybody else play the bass. The only problem is he's leaving, and now we got to find another bass player. So if anybody's got any ideas, let me know. But Carter Sickles on the bass, ladies and gentlemen. Beautiful. Beautiful, man. Really. And, each year we participate, Jazz at Lincoln Center, under the aegis of Wynton Marsalis, holds a festival and competition called Essentially Ellington. And what they do is each year they send out 8 arrangements. Half of them are always Duke Ellington and half are another composer. Like this year, it was Eddie Durham, the great trombonist who wrote for the Count Basie Band. And they send them to any school, band, or community group that requests them for free with a lot of videos and rehearsal tips. And then for those who are interested, you record 3 of them and you send them in, and they invite the top 15 bands to New York every May for a battle of the bands. And this is the 26th year they've done it. And one of the things that we do is we participate every year and we get great recordings. And they break the country into 5 regions. So our region is Florida, Georgia, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, North and South Carolina, 3 bands, high school bands from that region. And every year it's 2 bands normally come from the state of Florida. And we have some great bands at these art schools throughout the state. The best high school jazz band in the country is in Fort Lauderdale. The Dillard School over there, and then we have the Dreyfus School for the Arts, and New World Conservatory in Miami, Osceola School for the Arts. There's a lot of great ones on Kissimmee. And so we sent ours in. The difference is they rehearse 5 times a week for 2 hours a day, and we rehearse once a week for 2 hours. And we made an incredible recording this year, and unfortunately we didn't get selected to attend, but we made a great recording, and the students are always so well prepared. They walk into the recording scenario, and for 2 hours, we budget to not only set the sound, but make the recording. And this year was no different than any other year, and that we were done in 90 minutes, you know. So we were, they did a great job, and we're going to play the first of our selections that we submitted. And this one, Duke Ellington, used to spend a lot of time in Las Vegas with the band at one of the hotels, and he and Billy Strayhorn be sitting around for 6 weeks looking for stuff to do. And so, of course, they wrote music endlessly. And one time they said, hey, why don't we write an adaptation of the Peer Gynt suite for jazz band? And so, anyway, that's what they did. And when we were looking for music to play, our pianist, Chris, I said, well, if anybody has any suggestions, I'll take them and consider them. And he says, we should play this Anitra's Dance. And I said, yeah, it's a great idea. We haven't played it before. And as the judges noted in our comments it received, nobody really plays it. And it's such a great piece of music. And originally was written to feature the clarinet of Jimmy Hamilton. And
since we had our concert with Conrad Herwig in December, and then we had most of December off, we only had 3 weeks to learn and prepare the music to submit to Lincoln Center. And so I converted this one to feature our very talented pianist, Chris Socher. And it's from the Peer Gynt Suite, and this is Anitra's Dance. You'll also be hearing in the role of Johnny Hodges, our very talented lead alto saxophonist, Kevin Constantino, on this. Chris Socher, ladies and gentlemen. Kevin Constantino. Beatrice Otto on the drums. Beatrice Otto. Beatrice. Beatrice Otto on the drums. Yeah, Chris has been a longtime member of this group, and last year he wrote a three-movement suite for the band and piano, and also submitted a
composition and an arrangement for the Jazz at Lincoln Center competition. He's a talented composer and arranger. In fact, we're going to play one of his new arrangements on Dizzy Gillespie's Tintin Deo for our next concert. We're going to get right on rehearsing that next week. And also, I would be remiss if I didn't mention that Chris was a member of the 2022 Florida All-State Jazz Band. It's where all the high school jazz students in the entire state take an audition, and they take five trumpets, five trombones, five saxophones, and rhythm section. And Chris was chosen on piano, and they performed up in Tampa in January. So once again, for Mr. Chris Socher. Well, we're going to feature Chris again, and this is one of my favorite charts, and this comes from the great trumpeter Thad Jones, who was a member of the Count Basie Orchestra in the 1950s and 1960s, then started his own band with the great drummer Mel Lewis in 1965 that played every Monday night at the Village Vanguard in New York City, the Thad Jones-Mel Lewis Orchestra. Because the more and more things Thad Jones wrote for Count Basie, about 1962, Count Basie said, "Your stuff is too far out for me, and you need to start your own band." Not that it was bad, it was just that the style of Basie, he said that Thad had evolved and needed to have his own band to play this music. And so this is a great arrangement that Thad Jones wrote, that featured the piano of Sir Roland Hanna. This is going to feature the whole band, and this is one of my favorites. And this is called Basically Yours.
One, two, three, four, one, two.
Chris Socher on the piano. Chris Socher, stand up and take a bow. Stand up and take a bow. Ian Laufer on the lead trumpet. Ian Laufer. Josh Albanos on the drums. Yeah. Kevin Constantino on the lead alto. What a great arrangement. At this point, would like to invite a senior minister here at Naples United Church of Christ, Mr. Dawson Taylor. Oh, no, Dawson's not here. Becky will be coming up. Thank you.
Well, thank you. Dawson asked me if I would speak. They never do on Sunday morning, but, you know, I could preach. What do you think? This could preach. Yeah, I could preach. So before we take an offering, I'm beating in time so that you can get out your checkbooks and your bigger bills. This offering is going to go to all of those dear people who are suffering so much in Ukraine right now. Every single penny of this will go through the United Church of Christ to their work in Ukraine. And if you want to make a check out, you can make it out to Naples UCC, and you can put concert or Ukraine on the memo, and we'll be glad to take that. We are proud that Christian, where'd he go? You're back here, that your grandparents are here, and we still claim you as one of ours here. So I thank you for being here very much. I know they're so proud of you. And I would be remiss not to say, holy moly, how fortunate are these young people to work with the greats like Lou Delgado and Dan Miller. Give them a hand. Oh, my God. Amazing. And I want to take a minute and thank our AV team. There's people up in the balcony and then in this window over here that you can't see through. They're just amazing audiovisual, and they're fantastic people, and so give them a round.
Thanks, Becky. And we're going to continue now with another Count Basie chart, and this one comes from the pen of Sammy Nestico, who started writing for the U.S. Air Force Airmen of Note Jazz Ensemble in the 1950s, and then got affiliated with the Count Basie Orchestra in the 1960s, and wrote for that band all the way until 2 years ago when they had their Grammy-winning Christmas album, and he was contributing charts at the age of 98, and he passed away about a year and a half ago. But his incredible music lives on. And this is another blues you're going to hear from a bunch of people. And this is called The Front Burner.
Thank you.
Well, we heard from Mr. Jameson Moore once again in the role of Count Basie. I see Kevin Constantino on the alto saxophone. And we had a little trading of fours there on the trumpets between Ian Lauffer and Grayson Peterson. Hank Zhang on the trombone. Hank Zhang. Jack Boland on the baritone saxophone. Connor Stroh on the trumpet. Evan Carville on the vibes. And our fine lead trombonist, Rafael Perez Freeman. All right, buckle your seatbelts. This next one is one I like to pull out every couple of years when we get a new band, once they're ready for it. And this is another one, and this one comes from the pen of Quincy Jones for the Count Basie Orchestra. And it's an interesting story. Originally, 1959, the great Ray Charles was being interviewed, and he says, and if you know anything about Ray Charles, he says, I can make any music sound good. And there was a guest there, wealthy entrepreneur, and he said, any music? And he said, any music. And Ray Charles says, I'll bet you $100,000, 1959 money, that I can make anything sound good. And he goes, I'll take that bet. I want to hear you do country western. So Ray Charles took that bet. And his first call was to Quincy Jones and Count Basie to write an album of country western music for him. And that's one of Ray Charles's great records from 1960. Basie loved it so much, he had Quincy Jones adapt it for the big band. And we're going to hear from Chris Socher on this, and Raphael, and our fine lead trumpeter, Ian Lauffer, and of course, and Beatrice Otto on the drums. And everybody always loves this. We hope you enjoy I Can't Stop Loving You.
Thank you.
Chris Socher on the piano. Beatrice Otto on the drums. Beatrice Otto. Ian Lawford, lead trumpet. Rafael Perez Freeman on the trombone. Kevin Constantino, lead alto.
That one, that always gets us going. What a great, great, great piece of music. And we would like to perform the second of our submissions for the Essentially Ellington competition that we sent up. This is a beautiful ballad that was written to feature the great alto saxophonist from Duke Ellington's band, Johnny Hodges. And Duke Ellington had a writing partner, the great Billy Strayhorn, and they met in the late 30s, and they worked together, and many times we're never sure what Duke wrote or what Billy wrote, but they were one half of each other's heartbeat and wrote some of the greatest music of the 20th century. In 1967, Billy Strayhorn was stricken with a rare form of blood cancer and was in the hospital in New York City. And undergoing treatment and was not going well. And so his response was, I'm just going to write a whole nother album of music for Duke Ellington to record before I pass. And that record is called And His Mother Called Him Bill on RCA from 1967. And it's incredible, incredible music that he wrote. And this piece is one of the most, it's very heavy, emotionally and musically. And we recorded this for the competition and to feature our lead alto player, Kevin Constantino. And when I tell you, he did a magnificent job on this piece of music, and you're going to hear it right now, channeling the spirit and the genius of Johnny Hodges, yet bringing all his own personal touches to it. And we hope you enjoy this. It's an incredible piece of music. Mr. Kevin Constantino, and this is Billy Strayhorn's tune, Blood Count.
Four.
Kevin Constantino on the alto saxophone. Kevin Constantino, take a bow. Beautiful. Wow, what an incredible piece of music. That whole record, you know, just go home tonight and say, Alexa, play Duke Ellington, and his mother called him Bill. It's a staggering and staggering work of genius, featuring the great Clark Terry on trumpet and Johnny Hodges on the saxophone. It's heavy. And we'd like to play our third selection that we recorded for Essentially Ellington. And this is off a record, 1951, Masterworks. And this is one that doesn't get played very often. Of course, when you think about, you know, Winton choosing the music, this is the 26th year that they've done it. So, you know, of course, like Take the A-Train and Caravan and Perdido, all those have been done before. So they're always searching out new incredible works of music to include. And when we think about it, the Duke Ellington Orchestra recorded under Duke Ellington's guidance from the early 20s till the early 1970s until Duke's death. 50 years of music. It's staggering to think about as a musician, the true outpourings of raw genius, the most sophisticated composer of the 20th century for our music. Anyway, this is a good one. It's going to feature Chris Socher yet again. And this is called Smada.
Thank you.
Chris Socher at the piano. I'd like to take this opportunity to introduce all the members of the group, our other fine young pianist, Mr. Jameson Moore. You guys can stand up back there and wave. And Mr. Carter Sickles on the bass. Abraham Hernandez on the vibraphone. Also, Evan Carville on the vibraphone. Josh Albos on the drums. Beatrice Otto on the drums. And our saxophone section is led by Mr. Kevin Constantino. Also on saxophone, Josh Costapozo. Mr. Jalen Rivera. We have Juan Latour on the tenor saxophone. Juan Latour on the tenor saxophone. Mr. Jack Boland on the baritone saxophone. Our trombone section is led by Mr. Rafael Perez Freeman. We have Sam Eisenberg on trombone. Hank Zhang on trombone. Naomi Nerline on trombone. And Jack Moore on a bass trombone. Our trumpet section features an outstanding, outstanding lead trumpeter who is only a sophomore in high school, and he's just nailing it and swinging his tail off. Mr. Ian Lawfer on lead trumpet. Mr. Sam Ford on trumpet. Shreya Rajaram on the trumpet. Grayson Peterson on the trumpet. And Connor Stroh on the trumpet. I would like to say a few things. We want to thank everybody here, Becky, of course, and Dawson for creating such a wonderful place for music in Southwest Florida. It's really incredible. Every Sunday they have world-class music here, and members of the Naples Philharmonic or international soloists here each and every Sunday, and all kinds of music. And thank you, Becky, and everyone here at Naples United Church of Christ. And I do want to thank everybody at Artis-Naples because they have such a devotion to music education and young people. And it's really a rare thing. And that starts all from the top with Kathleen Van Bergen, who's the CEO and president of Artis-Naples. And David Filner, the executive VP. And Bonnie Theater, she's the director of education. And it's just, we have Grace Eugenitis, who is now our youth ensembles coordinator. Katie Moylanen just had another beautiful kid, so she's out of there. So we thank Katie for the first half of the year, and now we have Grace. And I want to thank these young people for working so hard each and every Wednesday. The commitments that these young people have these days in school are incredible. You know, their own band commitments that they have with the band and orchestra and jazz band, and then they have their academic commitments, and marching band in the fall is just a huge, huge investment, and then all their academic studies, and then if they're involved in sports or other activities, making the time to find time, because I always tell them, I said, we need to rehearse on Wednesdays, not practice our parts. So everyone shows up with their parts learned so we can really dig into the music, because we only have 2 hours a week. And so I thank you guys for such an incredible hard work so far this year and a great Essentially Ellington recording. And if you folks enjoyed what you heard, we have our next concert will be at Artis-Naples on March 28th. It's a Monday night. So if you like what you heard, you can come down and join us there. And we're going to close things out. And, you know, when I'm looking and putting an order together, you know, I consult with the lead trumpet player about what's best. But there was no doubt about what we would close today's program with. And if people are a fan of
the great genius of mambo music, Tito Puente. This is a famous recording of Tito Puente's from the 1950s mambo orchestra all through modern times. And this is a great one. Eddie Palmieri has done this, and it's just one of the great standards of mambo music. And we're going to hear from a few people on this, and we got a really tough trombone battle on deck, I think we've got here on this, in the spirit of salsa music. So this is Tito Puente's Ran Can Can, an arrangement by Mike Mossman.
The Naples Philharmonic Youth Jazz Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen. Let's take a bow, everybody. Take a bow. I thank you, and we hope to see you again real soon. Thank you very much. The Naples Philharmonic Youth Jazz Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen.